stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing for the playing of the national anthem.
Give me your way.
I'm not picking you up, so you'll be okay.
Please place the flag.
Oh, no.
Please. Thank you. One, two, three. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please keep standing.
We appreciate the musicians in the class of 2015 for offering us that Star Spangled Banner rendition. Thank you.
At this time, we will hear from our class salutatorian, Mr. Michael Spearman.
Teammates. I may not have been that involved. I mean, there are still people in the class I haven't talked to, but I can assure that they're all pretty good people. But I'm supposed to talk about conquering. Everybody has talked about what they've overcome in their life. The struggles and the hurdles that some of these graduates have been through would amaze you. Some scare you. But there's one obstacle that I don't know if I've heard anyone say yet. That obstacle is your best friend, your greatest enemy, your ride or die, that person that will be there whether you like it or not. That obstacle is you, us, the person you see when you look in the mirror or down at your hands. Like I said, I've been watching the class. Time and time again, I've seen my peers overcome issue after issue, problem after problem, situation after situation. But one thing that always seems to be holding us back is ourselves. When I say overcoming ourselves, I mean that maybe we should show a bit of humility and admit that we're wrong. Don't let your ego be the reason you got F's or got expelled or got put in jail. Or maybe we should be a little bit more confident, take that step forward to volunteer or audition for that one chance that we're all willing to get. Maybe we should be a little nicer to our teachers or our parents. Everyone's issue is different. And one thing that I've seen throughout the class, we've all improved and we've all grown and everyone's taking that little step to overcoming themselves, even if just a little bit. But we're not there just yet. So remember to push us, keep pushing us to overcome ourselves. So next time you're placed in a situation where you know what the right thing to do is, do it. Next time you're given the opportunity to excel in your career in any way, take it. Next time you're faced with a wall that seems impossible to overcome, climb it. Next time you're faced with hate, love them anyway. Next time you're faced with love, accept it. And next time you're faced with God, listen. It's not too late. Learn to overcome yourself. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael. This class has taken on the tagline of the conquerors because they have overcome many things, as Michael just mentioned, and they have more things that they are going to face as they go forward in the future. So we're proud of you and want you to continue to move forward and take that spirit with you. As conquerors, you all have been accomplished to receive many academic awards and scholarships. So at this time, we have some guests who are going to present some special awards. Ms. Delia Brown, Ms. Susan Dunbar-Bay, Mr. Ruben Mills, Ms. Carolyn James Weeks, Mr. Elbright Brown will present in that order, followed by our guidance counselor, Mr. Leslie Giles.
Good afternoon, everyone. It again gives me pleasure to be able to present awards at your graduation. And thinking back, I've done this since 2004. And I would like to thank Dr. Coe Brockington and Ms. Giles for always giving me this opportunity. And I'll try to speed it up because I can, you know, get involved. The first award I'm giving is the Robert M. Ford Memorial Scholarship. And that is a check for $300 and a plaque. And this award is given to a young lady and a young man who have overcome obstacles, maybe more so than other people. And I'm giving it because my brother Robbie, he's deceased now, but when he was a teenager at home, I had gone off and gotten married, but it was my mother and the kids. And we talk about having fathers in the house. My father was in and out, but I've explained to other classes that he was an alcoholic. So, and if any of you involved with alcoholics, you know what that can mean. But my brother was at home and he overcame. He went to Rutgers. He ended up working for DIFAS and the adoption part of that. So it gives me pleasure this time to present to the young lady and young man the Robert M. Ford Memorial Scholarship, and Janaya Lee and Javon Smith. Textbook Award. And in previous years, I would give this award on my own. But a couple of years ago, well, in 2012, actually 3 years now, I decided if I could start a foundation then I could have other people help me, and I did that this year. And so I had helped other people helping me with this award. And I started this textbook award way back when, 2004, because when I was in college, it was very, very difficult for me. I commuted, but sometimes I didn't have textbooks, so I had to borrow, and I had to ask friends, and ask my grandfather. And my mother, rest her soul, would scrub floors and do whatever she did so I could go to college. So sometimes it wasn't enough money left for textbooks, but I'm here. You know, I persevered, and with the help of others. So this is why I have established this award. And because it was a foundation, this year I gave applications out, and anyone in the senior class was eligible to put in an application, but everyone didn't do that. But I had a committee come, and my sister's sister and my youngest daughter helped me this time with the awards. And at this time, I'm proud to present 5 awards in the amount of $500 each for 5 students from here. And I would ask that the students please stay up on the stage, because I want to get a picture, if you don't mind, off to the side. So the first person receiving, and the name of my foundation is called Spare Change, Inc. You know, so you have a little spare change. And it's the Delia Ford Brown Textbook Award. So the first person is Tymea Boyer.
Good afternoon. Ms. Bay has asked me to present her award. I'm going to read the card that she selected. It says, "If you can dream it, you can do it." That's by Walt Disney. Make your dream big, huge, world-changing. Can't wait to see what you're going to do. Knowing you, it will be great. Congratulations, success, and best wishes for a bright future. And this award goes to Denisha Branch.
This is my 9th time addressing the graduating class at Creative Arts. And it gives me great pleasure to give an award to the very first student that I met when I became employed by the Camden City School District, Mr. Jamal Dickerson. Successful as you, and you're going to be my mentor. Who does that, right? So it gives me great pleasure to provide this award to the young man who will continue to receive this award every semester you're enrolled in college. Omar Tapp.
Good afternoon, everyone, and congratulations to the graduates. My name is Mr. Brown, Albright Brown. I'm a visual arts instructor. I teach grades 8, 10, and also 12. This is one of those moments that's, it's a sad moment for me, but it's also a happy moment, of course, because my senior visual arts students are a group of students that myself and Mr. Bruce Greff, if Mr. Greff would raise his hand, please, right in the back of the room. We had the wonderful opportunity to have been able to audition the students, and you know, to watch them grow. It's one of those things that makes you feel really good, and to hear about, you know, them going to college and doing all kinds of other wonderful things. We celebrated birthdays in my class. Where's Dajane? We always call her Mom. And also Marco Montiel. Chance to see all kinds of wonderful things with the seniors, and again, thank you, seniors, for that opportunity. But this award is presented to a talented, hard-working, well-mannered, determined student who has always been willing to use their talents to benefit our school community. On behalf of my principal, Dr. DeVitico Brockington, friends of the Visual Arts Department, and Mr. Brian McAndrews, and Mr. Bruce Greff, and myself, we would like to present the Visual Arts Award, the 2015 Visual Arts Award, which is wonderful, to Tiani Robinson.
Good afternoon. My name is Carolyn James Weeks, and I'm the Executive Director for the New Jersey Foundation of Leadership, Education, and Arts Development, Incorporated. To the superintendent, the board members, and I'd like to have Mrs. Cobrockington come forward. Cobrockington since she was a young girl, and we're sorority sisters. I knew her parents extremely well. One of her mentors was Mrs. Cecilia Brown Cannon, who was the first executive director of NJF LEAD and the person who orchestrated NJF LEAD. And every year for the last 5 years, we have awarded us an award to creative, I still call you creative and performing arts. I am very sorry. I know this is Morgan Village Creative Academy, excuse me. But this is an award to the school, and we're going to ask Mrs. Davida Cook-Rockington to use it as she sees fit. In prior years, and I have to mention Mr. Dickerson there in the back. In prior years, could you stand up, Mr. Dickerson? He has supported all the activities. Younger Mr. Spearman. His older brother used to perform for us, as did he. And I don't know, is Mr. Spearman, Mr. or Mr. and Mrs. Spearman here? Could you please stand? When the band played for our fashion show, Mr. Spearman transported every single band member to our activity. So I just can't tell you how wonderful it is. The young people here at Creative Arts Morgan Village, you should be so proud of your school, of your community, of your board. I'm a graduate of Philadelphia High School for Girls in Philadelphia, and I don't think we got more support than you do. I just want to wish you luck. It's a hard, hard job to go to college. Make sure if you just do the one thing that I was told the first day I walked into college. Go to class. Go to class. Have fun, but go to class. Call your parents and don't just ask for money. When you call your parents, say, this is your child and I love you, then ask for the money. I think everybody who's going to college knows what I mean. You usually just call and say, Mom, I'm broke. But just say, I'm alive, I love you, and then you might get a little money. But we'd like to give this to the school. It's a small token of our esteem for Dr. Brockington and for this school. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Good afternoon again to students, faculty, staff, parents, family, and guests. Regarding these scholarships and awards, many of them the students competed for, and some of them, as you see in your program, they were awarded by the scholarship donors. There were a couple that weren't mentioned in the brochure, and I want to just mention the Get in School, Stay in School award was given to Richard Williams this year. And that is so pertinent because, yes, it's hard enough to get in school, but it's even harder to stay in school, folks. Okay, so always remember that never give up, and you always have help. You have help here. Your family supports you. Your advisors at college to keep you going, because there will be obstacles. But I like the name of that, Get in School, Stay in School. Also, the Masjidin Noor Award was given this year to Nala Johnson and Jamal Dickerson. And the Lions Club Award was given to Stephanie Rosario. The other ones I've mentioned. Whether they're going on to a state college or a technical school, perhaps a private university or a community college, you are all going somewhere, students. Just keep in mind, it's important to have a destination. You are all going somewhere. And remember what I said about keeping on the path. As you travel your path, remember that you have what it takes to succeed, and today is proof of that. But you need to always build on your successes, because there will be obstacles, there'll be bumps in the road, ditches in the road, bridges washed out, and all of those metaphors, okay? But none of those can keep you down if you always let your light shine and know that you have a mission.
So keep going as far as you can go, whether that's bachelor's, master's, PhD, CEO, entrepreneur, head of your own company, the sky's the limit. And you do have what it takes to walk your path. I'm not going to dwell on it. I lost my speech. You probably saw me scribbling. But God bless you. I don't want to say goodbye because it's too hard to say goodbye, but I'll say that we'll meet again, and bless you all. Thank you.
At this time, we're going to have remarks from our very own Camden City School Superintendent, Mr. Paymont Hunterford.
Apologies that we were running a few minutes late here along with our board members. We have all five of our high school graduation ceremonies in one day, so if one is just a few minutes running over, it has a domino effect. Thank you all. I want to thank, beginning with Dr. Joe Brockington, the faculty here, the family members, the parents, the grandparents, the siblings, all of you. What we all know in this room is so evident in a moment like this. There is remarkable greatness and talent in the city of Camden. And let's give the class of 2015 another huge round of applause. This is a special place for me personally, and I've gotten to know a few of the graduating seniors quite well. And I know each of them has a very unique journey and has overcome certain obstacles and challenges. And so, in moments like this, as an adult, as a superintendent, it's basically a requirement for me to impart a few words of advice, but I'll be very, very brief. My words of advice are quite simple. You don't know what you don't know. You don't know what you don't know. You might be asking yourself, what do you mean by that? I'm graduating from high school, I must know a lot. But it seems like, based on your reaction, you know exactly what I mean by that. Like, my advice comes from personal experience, but also having spoken to so many of your prior colleagues and peers who have graduated from school here, students who are in your shoes as recently as last year, who went off to college, military, or directly into the workforce. And as I keep in touch with them, there's a lot that I've learned from them. And what I can tell you is they didn't know how long it would take to get basic training. They didn't realize how many steps were involved in finding a job. They didn't realize that financial aid doesn't actually cover everything as it relates to your tuition, room, and board. They didn't realize it's really hard to take notes in college when there are 100 other students sitting in the room with you. So they got a wake-up call, just like you're going to get a wake-up call in the next few weeks, months, and years, and you're going to hit those bumps in the road. But if you commit yourself and you draw on this massive network of support from family members to community leaders to faculty to friends, you're going to be just fine. So I just want to leave you with this. I'm going to share with you a few verses from a song that I can remember listening to when I was about your age. It comes from Nazis the Illmatic. Only the strong will continue. I know you have it in you. I know you have it in you. You are incredibly strong. You're strong because of the faculty here. You're strong because of the administration here. You're strong because of your family, and your broader family, I should say. So keep all of those people in mind. I know you have it in you. Congratulations.
Say, and this is very important, students, along your as you walk your path, it's very important to help somebody, because we all want success, and monetary, financial success is great, but we also have to have success of a spiritual feeling within ourselves, to know that we are helping others, whether that means mentoring, tutoring, helping your little siblings with their homework, helping the elders in any way you can, assisting in your neighborhood, in your church, or it could mean just telling your success story, because all of you do have at least one success story. So it's very important to help folks, to reach back, just like all of our donors, I forgot to thank our scholarship donors. Reach back and help somebody else. Just keep the chain going. It's very important. Thank you.
I was honored and grateful to be able to speak to the seniors at the senior luncheon and yearbook dedication. So I basically said what I needed to say to them then, but I'd just like to say thank you again for being a wonderful class. And when I sit here and watch you, the time went so quickly, the 4 years, and I'm really sad to see you go. And I don't say that all the time, but really sad to see you go, because you were a wonderful class, a body of students who worked diligently, who were extremely respectful. When I'm fussing in the hall, asking you to do things, never, maybe didn't feel like doing it, but never a word of disrespect. And I thank you for that, and I thank you for representing our school always in such a positive manner. I would miss all of you, the couple I did have to have in the office on occasion, numerous occasions, just a couple. I will truly miss you. Really, because we became great, I felt like your second mother. And then I felt like your family, because I was on the phone to your mother and your father all the time. So I'm going to miss you. Yes, yes, I am. Sincerely, I love you all, and I'm proud of you. I'm proud of what you've accomplished. I know some of your situations, and I was getting a little filled up sitting here, so thinking about some of the things that some of you have had to endure as young people, some things that an adult my age probably would fold if they were under some of the same situations. So I say to each of you, and those of you probably, you know who I'm speaking to, I'm extremely proud that you're sitting here today, because a lot of people wouldn't be. They could not withstand the pressure that some of you have had to withstand for many years. So I'm very proud of you. Stay strong. When you go to college, remember there are people that love you and care about you, and you can always come back, email us, you know, staff, me, many of us support you. So again, continue to do the things that you're doing, and I know you're going to achieve greatness. So at this time, I have the honor of conferring your diplomas. So I ask our board president, our superintendent, and our board members, if you would come up. It is my honor to inform you that the students of the Creative Arts Morgan Village Academy, oh, they're gonna come up? Oh, okay. Well, Ms. Blackshear and Mr. Mahanafar have something to say. I'll wait till they go.
Okay.
At this time, Creative Arts Morgan Village Academy class of 2015 have met the graduation requirements set forth. forth by the New Jersey Department of Education of the Camden City School District. I recommend to the Advisory Board President, Mrs. Catherine Blackshear, and the Superintendent of the Camden City Schools, Mr. Paymon Muhanafard, that each of the candidates of the class of 2015 be recognized as graduates from the Creative Arts Morgan Village Academy. Mr. Muhanafard, Ms. Blackshear, and the members of the Camden City Board of Education, I present to you the class of 2015.
Camden City School District Advisory Board, I am pleased to accept the graduates of Creative Arts Morgan Village Academy School. I would like to extend my compliments to the staff for preparing the class for this day, to the parents and guardians who have supported them, and to the class of 2015 who have worked so hard to meet the requirements for a high school diploma. Based on the recommendation of the high school principal, Dr. Brockerton, We can now proceed with the ceremony and recognize the individual members of the class of 2015.
The class of 2015.
Jonathan Aponte.
Michael Spearman. Yanaka Merkley. Maya Miller.
At this time, we're going to
Congratulations to the class of 2015. We bid you farewell, and a huge thanks to all who attended. Thank you all for making this a memorable event. Congratulations, seniors.
Skilled class, extraordinary in talent and rich in creativity. Each and every one of us pride ourselves on being performers. And although I quote the well-known playwright Shakespeare quite often, I find it only appropriate to use his metaphor, all the world's a stage. Because the world is our stage, we are all performers awaiting the cues in this production we call life. Just as all productions go, we have our many different characters who serve purpose. Each of these characters have their own exits and entrances in our life, so it's up to you to distinguish the leading, supporting roles, and background characters. We strive to be leading roles in our own lives, so that is why it is always important to never allow tree number 3 or other irrelevant roles to determine the fate of our show. This ceremony is when we go our separate ways, and it creates one of the biggest exits certain characters can make. But choose your role wisely, because the show ain't over yet. There are still more conflicts, plots, climaxes, character building, foreshadowing, and resolutions to come. So be strong and conquer your role, because we are performers, we are conquerors, and we are the class of 2015. Before we go, remember, this isn't curtain call just yet. It's only intermission.
Michael, would you also join us at the podium as well? On behalf of the staff and students here at the Creative Arts Warwick Village Academy, we'd like to thank you two gentlemen for being role models, for being model students, and for being just great general people overall. We have these small tokens of appreciation and continue to bid you well.
At this time, we're going to have our Alumni of the Year Award presented by Ms. Maya Miller.
Alumni is important. And we appreciate these young ladies for what they give back to our school. Naima Galefsi. Naima Galefsi was a student in the class of 2006. She was one of our Naima went on to study at Morgan State University. She currently has given back to the community. We started giving this award several years ago because our alumni were doing great things. We like to accomplish them at this, to recognize their accomplishments at this level, but additionally those who have gone on, gotten their college degrees, have started their careers, and still find time to give back to our community. So Naima has opened a dance studio here in the neighborhood, and she has offered dance classes as school. She's done a lot for the dance community. We appreciate her. Wanted to honor and recognize her today. Our second honoree is also a member of the class of 2006, Miss Nahema Jackson Brown, who currently or recently just had a baby, so was unfortunate to join us today. But Nahema was a member of the class, also in the National Honor Society. She was a local student who traveled with the award-winning choir. She went on to American University and currently lives back here in the city and works at the community center, giving back. She's volunteered at our school, helping with our poetry club, preparing for our Louder Than the Bomb. So it's always great that we honor and recognize our alumni. It's all really Maya's voice that you hear, not mine. So additionally, we have several alumni who are here in the graduation audience. Would you please stand? Because we always like to honor and recognize you. I see McKinney, George, Stephen. They all come back with degrees from South Carolina State University, Florida A&M. Ithaca University, Jackson State, Fayetteville State University, Berklee College of Music, Richard Stockton University, Oberlin Conservatory College of Music. So our alumni do great things, our current graduating class will do greater things, and we recognize and honor you at next year's graduation. We appreciate you all. Thank you.
And now we will hear from our guest speaker, introduced by Miss India Robinson.
Under the instruction of Nasir Dickerson. While in her first year of playing, she joined a group called the Little Jazz Giants, led by Hassan Sabri. This group consisted of middle school students playing to pursue music as a career. During her time in the group, she performed at various jazz festivals, such as the Cape May Jazz Festival and the Tony Williams Jazz Festival. Doing so allowed her to gain a deeper understanding behind the discipline of importance of music. She then continued her journey at the Camden Creative and Performing Arts High School. She was in marching band, concert band, small jazz and ensemble, and the big band, all under the direction of Jamal Dickerson, as well as other ensembles inside and outside of the program. Throughout high school, she has received many awards. She has received national medals from the NAACP AXL competition, over 20 Best Soloist Awards from various high school jazz festivals, Monterey Next Generation Jazz Festival Best Overall Soloist, Featured Stories in the Philadelphia Carrier Post, and many others. She went on to graduate third in her class with 3 full scholarships. She now attends Berklee College of Music in Boston, Massachusetts, where she studies with many amazing musicians on the scene. She is currently being mentored by Grammy Award winning artist Jill Scott and the dynamic saxophonist Tia Fuller. Under their mentorship, she has the opportunity to perform on BET's Black Girls Rock with Janelle Monae and receive a Rising Star Award from Jill Scott's Blues Big Foundation on BET's UNCF and Evening of Stars. Throughout her career so far, she has the opportunity to perform with Shirley E., Bootsy Barnes, Tia Fuller, Ralph Peterson, Terry Lynn Carrington, Mimi Jones, Victor Lewis, Janelle Monae, Jerry Allen, Warren Wolf, Kristen McBride, and many more. She is currently the band leader of her group entitled Arnetta Johnson and Sunny, Sounds Uplifting Nobility Through Notes in You. Arnetta's goal is to allow people to be uplifted and live in the moment through music. Everyone, please welcome Arnetta Johnson.
Thank you. It is an honor and a privilege to be standing before you all this afternoon, the graduating class of 2015. It was only 3 years ago, just 3 years ago, that I was sitting where you are now. Although you feel as if you've accomplished this yourself, it was also through the help of your parents, your teachers, and your peers. Throughout your time, I am sure you have had run-ins and various encounters with different issues throughout your high school career. But I guarantee you, with each conflict, someone was there to help you through it. Now, I know somebody is sitting there saying, nah, nobody was there. But you're sitting here, aren't you? You all have conquered these years that will take you into various endeavors. Being a young adult from Camden, New Jersey, I have learned a very valuable lesson from over the years. That is, from dealing with our circumstances, in order for us to truly be successful, we have to strive to overachieve. In today's society, your traditional student may simply achieve. Realistically, being from the urban area, we don't have a traditional society setting. This isn't a bad thing. We have all the examples of what to do and what not to do right outside the door. Here's an example. You go outside, and as usual, you see the boys on the block. They're there from the break of dawn until the late hours of the night. To me, that takes a lot of dedication. On a negative note. Now, on a positive note, imagine taking that same amount of dedication and applying it to something positive on a daily basis. Think about where you'll be in 3 years. I happen to have applied this method to my musicianship, dedication. From the break of dawn to the late hours in the night, I am practicing or working on music in one way or another. By doing so, I have been able to drastically improve my skill. It was difficult, but by building up my hard work muscle through dedication, I was able to conquer. I was able to conquer through receiving a full scholarship to 3 of the top music schools in the country, New School, Oberlin, and Berklee College of Music. Clearly, I chose to go to Berklee. As I went to my first week of classes, I was in for a huge culture shock. I went from going to a school where everyone could relate to each other, everyone had the same talk, style, even the same eating habits, to going to Berklee, where no one had similar backgrounds, no one spoke the same, and almost no one looked like me at all. The only thing we had in common was literally music. Again, from conquering my struggles through hard work and dedication, this made me stronger and open for people to help me. Although I didn't have the same resources as other students prior to college, my professors saw my dedication through my work ethic. At school, my nickname suddenly became the girl always in the practice room. From the practice room girl, I became the, oh, she can actually play. From the, oh, she can actually play, to the, she's getting all the gigs. For a few months, everyone was supportive and cheering me on. Suddenly, I went from the, she's getting all the gigs, to the, oh, she's getting all the gigs and she's a girl. There was a huge shift in the atmosphere. The peers I thought had my back didn't. There was so much shade being thrown. At the time, it got a little discouraging to hear people disregard my musical abilities only to make it about me being just a girl. Negative energy like this can build up so bad that even you start to believe it. The only way to conquer negative energy is to focus. Through all of your endeavors, stay extremely focused. You should be so focused that even on your bad days, you're better than most people on their best. I just finished an amazing book by Don Miguel Ruiz entitled The Four Agreements. These four agreements lead to personal freedom and a peace of mind. The first agreement is, be impeccable with your word. The tongue is a very powerful weapon. Be careful what you put out into the atmosphere. You put out negative energy, you receive negative energy. You put out positive energy, you receive positive energy. Follow up with your word. The second agreement is, don't take anything personally. If someone makes the decision to make a negative comment towards you, don't take it to heart. If anything, realize that that negativity is in their reality and not yours. The third agreement is, don't make assumptions. Always seek facts before coming to a conclusion about something without any information. The last and final agreement is to always do your best. Never shorten yourself. As artists, we have to realize that we never know who is in the audience listening and watching. In conclusion, time waits for no one. Go seize the moment while it is at hand. Now don't go out there and miss your opportunity because you are waiting for your friends.
Amen.
In your first year of college, start making plans for when you graduate from college. You never know. 3 years from now, your mentor may be Jill Scott and the famous saxophonist Tia Fuller. Your face may be the main advertisement of your school, and your potential potential balls may be Beyonce. Always be ready so you don't have to get ready. Thank you.
Netta's name came to mind, and it was just, wow, it's a great choice. And awesome. India looks up to her. I was like, oh, we'll have her introduce her. And it just worked out perfectly. And you did a great introduction of our speaker. Netta, we didn't think otherwise that you would give us a great speech. So on behalf of the class, we appreciate your time and your talent. And I'm sure Mr. Dickerson agrees that it's been a pleasure to have been her teacher, right?
Yes, it was. I enjoy hearing her mess up in that high note that I could play better than her or something, even though I'm a saxophone player. But not now. Woo! You need to hear her.
So at this time, we didn't feel that our graduates got their just due to hear their name called. So audience members, we need your cooperation to please refrain from shouting and screaming. Graduates, we're going to call your names one final time. When your name is called, just stand and smile at the guests, and then we'll be prepared to move on with our program. So remain standing.
Jonathan Aponte.
Michael Spearman.
Shabria Smith.
Yaleka Lopez.
Kimberly Flores.
Maya Miller.
Desiree Coloma.
Nala Johnson.
Brian Castillo.
Lauren Lewis.
Carl Adams.
Malachi Adams.
Tymir Boyer.
Denisha Branch.
Charleston Clark.
Crystal Cosme.
Mark Anthony Cubetto.
Zaire Daniels.
Jamal Dickerson II.
Naja Edwards.
Odari Gomez.
Daria Grant.
Brianna Holmes.
Kenyatta Israel Jr.
Raymond A. Jett III.
Anthony Jones Jr.
Janiyah Lee.
Marco Montiel.
Dwayne Patterson.
Tatiana Pettiford.
India Robinson.
Nate Robinson.
Tiani Robinson.
Matthias Roman.
Stephanie Rosario.
Farron Rouse.
Kenyatta Sabri.
Jawan Smith.
Ayana Stone.
Tamia Sturgis.
Omar Talbot.
Dominique Tantarias.
Dajani Taliban.
Karina Velez.
Zaire Webb.
Jamira Williams.
And Richard Williams.
Again, the class of 2015.
Presenting, that will be Mr. Kenyatta Israel. Thank you.
Give it up for your class of 2015.